As the world grapples with escalating geopolitical tensions, defense giants like Lockheed Martin, RTX, and Northrop Grumman have not just survived, but thrived. And with just a few minutes left until the closing bell rings on Wall Street, we're looking at how to navigate the defense sector with the Yahoo Finance Playbook. Joining us now, Jason Gursky, Citi Managing Director and Lead Analyst covering aerospace and defense. So, Jason, first of all, sort of set the table for us about the defense environment now versus other eras. And whether you think, as a whole, this is a good area to buy right now.
Yeah, I'm constructive on the outlook for the defense industry. Geopolitical tensions are elevated, as we all know. We have active conflicts going on in Europe and the Middle East. And you have this kind of long-term kind of detente or cold war that was potentially developing here between the United States and China. So as the United States looks at the threat environment and prepares a strategy to kind of address that, they look to deterrence as the number one thing that they want to invest in. And military modernization is the way to deter our potential enemies. And that's what we're seeing today. We're seeing rising budgets. And the modernization of a lot of military kit. Additionally, given the support that we've given Ukraine and Israel, we're also needing to, replace munitions that have been expended in those conflicts. So we've got, things going on here in the near term with active conflicts and munitions replacements and restocking. And then the long-term investments that we're making to deter potential enemies over the longer term.
Jason, I'm curious. We had Trey Stevens on the show recently from defense tech startup Anduril. There's a startup, Jason, now valued at $14 billion. I'm just curious how much of a competitive threat you think these defense tech startups, like the Andurils of the world, are, Jason, to the just the big, entrenched, traditional military suppliers you cover.
Yeah, look, I think companies like Anduril are a really healthy thing for the ecosystem. They're demonstrating an ability to bring innovation to the table, to iterate quickly on innovation. That's not to say that the big guys aren't doing something similar. They all have, venture arms. They're investing in smaller companies that are helping them to innovate as well. To your point, though, it is maybe a bit of a zero-sum game in the sense that, defense budgets are what they are. They're sized the way that they are. And for companies like Anduril to generate new revenue streams, not necessarily growing the TAM, the addressable market, they're going to end up taking share. So, look, it's a healthy dynamic for the taxpayers. It's a healthy environment for investors as well to see this competitive tension going on between the likes of Anduril and some of the big guys. But it's a big pie that's growing, and I think that there's probably going to be room for everybody to be pretty healthy in this environment.
And Jason, when it comes to the stocks that you're recommending for investors here, I struck not just by the sort of Lockheeds and General Dynamics, the really big guys that you like, but you also like some lesser known names that are more parts suppliers to those bigger players. I'm looking at a TransDigm, for example, or a Ducommun, which was not a name I knew, to be frank. So why do you like some of those guys?
Yeah, TransDigm's a bit more of a commercial aerospace company. They do provide quite a bit of parts that go into the defense industry. But I think most investors like that one because of its exposure to the airline industry and by those that are buying new aircraft and servicing those aircraft. They've also been a serial acquirer, rolling up a pretty fragmented industry. So our thesis there is all the goodness that's going on in commercial aerospace and this fragmented industry that they have the opportunity to go roll up. Ducommun and TransDigm will also benefit from some of the dynamics that are going on in defense, but that's not the most important part of the story. Ducommun, it's a kind of a split aerospace and defense company, parts supplier. They've been going through some restructuring efforts to help reduce their cost structure, which gives them a path, I think, to higher margins over time. And they are exposed to some of the missile programs. I talked early on about the restocking of a bunch of munitions that have been used in both Ukraine and in the Middle East. The customers that they have on hand there, the Raytheons in particular of the world, are going to see a restock restocking going on of all these munitions and growth, and Ducommun's going to be directly exposed to that. So that's why we were constructive on that one.
Jason, great to have you on the show today. Thanks so much for your time and those stock picks.
You're welcome.